king. Come let us bow at his feet. He has done great things. See what our Savior has done. See how his love overcomes. He has done great things.
Come on, wherever you're at, if you're at home, you're in your car, whatever you're doing, we know that there's some restrictions with the church, but there's no restrictions with our worship tonight. So wherever you're at, let's go ahead and worship the Lord.
There's no reason for sadness, 'cause you put joy in my soul. You've turned my mourning to gladness, and now I sing a new song. There's no reason for sadness. You put joy in my soul.
You've turned my mourning to gladness, and now I sing a new song. So all night long, all day long, I will sing of your great love. No one else could have done all the things that you have done. Everybody singing and shouting, whoa. Everybody's praising with freedom, whoa. There is no one like our God. Come on, say that out tonight. There is no one like our God. There is no one. There is no one like our God. Come on, there's no reason. Reason for sadness. 'Cause you put joy in my soul. You've turned my mourning to gladness. And now I sing a new song. Come on, there's no reason. There's no reason for sadness. You put joy in my soul. See, you turn my mourning to gladness. And now I sing a new song. So all night long, all day long, I will sing of your great love. No one else could have done all the things that you have done. Everybody singing and shouting, whoa. Everybody's praising with freedom, whoa. Come on, say, there is no one like our God. There is no one like our God. There is no one. There is no one like our God. There is no one like our God. Say, oh.
Come on, gang, God's anointed now. Generation in the house. Come on, somebody. Come on, gang, God's anointed now. Generation, you being there at your house, Facebook and YouTube right now, I want to challenge you guys right now to post that you love Jesus. Share it. Share it with your family. Share it with your loved ones. Because we all need Jesus. Not just me. Not just you. But all need Jesus. Right now, we want to welcome you guys out to our Friday night gang service. Jesus' name. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Father God, have your way, Father God, with this service, Father. Have your way, Father God. Touch their hearts, Father. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Jesus, we worship you tonight, God. Jesus, we worship you, God. Lord, we want to be in your presence. Lord, we want to be where you are, God. We just want to be with you tonight. Come on, if that's your desire. Come on, if that's your desire tonight, to just be in his presence. Come on, that same attitude, that same worship, that you have when you're in the church and the four walls. I want to encourage you to have that same attitude of worship right there wherever you're at. Jesus, we worship you, God. Oh, we love you. Your presence is all that I need. Your glory is all. It's all I want to see. I won't go unless you go before me. I'm waiting for you. I'm waiting for you. Waiting for you. Come on, see your presence. Your presence is all. It's all that I need. Your glory is all. All I want to see. And Lord, open the heavens over me. I'm desperately waiting. I'm anticipating a touch from you. Say, I just want to be. I just want to be in your presence. I just want to stay here forever, kneeling down at your feet. I'm giving you it. I just want to be in your presence. I just want to stay here forever, kneeling down at your feet, giving you everything. Say, your presence is all. It's all that I need. Your glory is all. It's all I want to see. And Lord, open the heavens over me. I'm desperately waiting. I'm anticipating a touch from you. Come on, if you want to be in his presence, say, I just want to be in your prayer. Oh, I want to stay here forever, kneeling down at your feet, giving you, I just want to be in your presence. I just want to stay here forever, kneeling down at your feet, giving you, I just want to be in your presence. I just want to stay here forever, kneeling down at your feet. I'm giving you everything. I just want to be in your presence. I just want to stay here forever. I'm kneeling down at your feet, giving you, say, I just want to be in your presence. I just want to stay here forever, kneeling down at your feet. I'm giving you everything. I just wanna be in your presence. I just wanna stay here forever, kneeling down at your feet. I'm giving you it. I just
right there where you're at. You may find yourself at home.
I just wanna stay here forever.
Right there on Facebook. and on YouTube. I want to encourage everybody to continue to worship, to continue to lift up your hands to God.
I just want to be in your presence. I just want to stay here forever, kneeling down at your feet.
I believe that God wants to do something special tonight. It doesn't, you can find yourself at home right now, but hey, God's still able to show up. God's still able to move. God's still able to deliver that miracle, that healing that you've been fighting for, that you've been seeking for. So right there where you're at, continue to worship. Continue to lift your hands. Oh, we praise you, God. We worship you, Lord. We thank you, God, for everything that you're doing, God. We thank you, Lord, for our gang nights, God. Thank you, God, for our church, Lord. You are great, God. You are beautiful. And there is no one like you, God. Oh, Lord, we thank you, Father God. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm giving you everything. I'm giving you everything. I'm giving you everything. I'm giving you everything. Giving you everything.
In Psalms.
Jesus.
In 1 Psalms 2:2, there is no one holy like the Lord. There is no one besides you. There is no rock like our God. If you know our God, right, is your rock. If you know there is no one like him, and if you know that, I want you to give a radical praise to Jesus. I want you to drop a comment right now, how good he is, how great he is. If he's your rock, if he's your foundation, and if you stand on him and you build on him, I want you to drop that in the comments right now. Because, hey, I believe God wants to do something great tonight. And we're thankful for every single person that's tuning in right there on Facebook and on YouTube. And I just have some quick announcements, some reminders. You can go ahead and take a seat wherever you may find yourself. Amen. Worship did a great job. Amen. So we just have some, I have some quick reminders for you. Next week, go ahead and tell your neighbor right there, wherever you may find yourself. Next week is the Third Wave Con online experience, which will be starting on Monday, and we will go all the way through to Friday. So for Friday night, for gang night, we will be watching the third wave online, right? Also, we'll have Taco with the Gang, and that'll be an outside fellowship. It's just a way of getting to know you, right? And we want to be able just to fellowship and enjoy a good time. That'll be our gang night for the 31st of this month. Also, we want to encourage for you to bring out a friend, to invite a friend. It's gonna be pretty awesome. Also, I want to encourage everybody to follow us on social media, VO_Barstow_gang. If you have an Instagram, hello. If you have a Facebook, you know, we want to encourage you to follow us on our social media platforms. Also, this Sunday service, we will be having service online. You don't want to miss out. It will start at 10 a.m. And what we want to do right now is I want to introduce a special. And maybe we can take this pulpit off. I want to introduce a special right on. I'm gonna just let you enjoy it, amen.
Before I start, my name is Albert. I'm 25 years old, and I just want to give glory to God. I just want to thank him for everything and thank my leaders. And I want to thank God for my talents that he's given to me. And it says not to hold your talents, but amen, glory to God.
Pull up on 10 with ease. Know what it meant to be. Money don't grow on trees. So I got a hands on me. Glad I
grandma got her visa. She about to take a plane. Shout out to Alicia. Her son about to take the game. Ain't no worries, ain't no hurry. I about really fighting for me. No side, no me. That's lil' holy. I'm on 10 with all my woadies. I've been good. I'm okay. Dodging bull like a lay. This my year. This my day. Oh, damn. I just, I'm on a whole nother level. I'm dodging the devil. They hitting my line and I block. Finally better. They watching novellas. But I need the drama to stop. This that gleam. This that super speed. Skirt, skirt on the beat. This that beam. This that 116. You can't touch the team. Pull up on 10 with ease. Know what it meant to be. Money don't grow on trees. Son got the hands on me. Gloria, gloria, Dios. Gloria, gloria, Dios. Gloria, gloria, Dios. Gloria, gloria, Dios.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Tu fidelidad. I remember screaming that off the top in the south. Flow it up, gloria, yeah. Whoa, ay, night and ay, day. Youngin' with the Royal Range. Boy Scout, had them toys out from the AG on the day. Whoa, missionary minded, ain't no way around it. Understand about it, Timmy told me, go, I got it. Yeah, thank you, Ramos, old days. Thank you, mama, you prayed. I never forgot how you gon' stop, Miami Dade. Pull it to the studio, run it like Rufio. This ain't even finished, bro. But I got my own studio, what?
Pull up on 10 with ease, know what it meant to be. Money don't grow on trees, so I got a hands on me. Gloria, gloria, Dios. Gloria, gloria, Dios. Gloria, gloria, Dios. Gloria, gloria, Dios. Whoa!
Amen, amen. You guys still ready here tonight, gang? Come on, how many of us enjoyed that dance right there? Give my brother Albert a hand. Amen. Is the gang in the house? Amen. Is the gang in the house? Come on now. I'm talking to those live on Facebook and YouTube. Can you make some noise right where you're at? Come on now. It's God's anointed now generation. Amen. Like my brother said before he even jumped into the dance, he's talking about he ain't going to hide his gift. He ain't going to hide his talent. I know he talked about the scripture where the he had the one, the five. He said he was given five talents, and he was the one that hit it. Amen. And there's a long story that goes on after that, but you can look it up. Amen. I'm not going to go into it. But let's not hide our talents, because God wants to use us in a special way. And I believe each and every one of us has a gift, has a talent that God wants to use. Amen. So we want to encourage you. During this time, we have some time. Tell your neighbor, you got some time. Tell the person next to you, you got some time, amen, to develop your gifts and your talents. Amen. So when God, come on, that opens that door, you could use your gifts and you could give them some glory. You could reach some people in a special way. There's so many different things we could go into, talking about talents, talking about gifts. But here tonight, I want to talk about worship. God's anointed now generation, are we still, come on now, in the attitude of worship? Can we still lift our hands? Can we still sing the songs? Amen. Amen. And can we still give unto the Lord, amen, what he deserves? Amen. And so, but before I go into the giving, I want to just encourage you. There's three ways to give. There's the in-person giving, and it's an hour before service, an hour afterwards. We'll be here so you can come and bring your tithe traditionally. And also, we have our online giving, victoryoutreachbarstow.com. You could give there on that website. Also, you could download the Givelify app, and there you could put a little bit of information, you know, and then you'll have that app, and it's way it's more convenient so you can give, and you just, it's tap to give, and it's a simple way of giving. It's an easy way, and it's an effective way. So I have a scripture I want to share with you guys. Amen. And it's found in Proverbs 18:16. And it stood out a little bit differently to me here today. And so as I was reading it, I was just talking about gifts and talking about talents. I was wondering, wow. And so I'm going to just go ahead and read it. Proverbs 18:16, a New International Version, the NIV. A gift opens the way and ushers the giver into the presence of the great. I'm going to read it one more time. A gift opens the way and ushers the giver into the presence of the great. In other words, it says great men, and other translations say the great. When we're talking about greatness, amen, I could think about God. I could think about great men of God. I could think about great people of God. I could think about the great things that God has in store for you. But it talks about a gift, amen, that we're called to use, that we're called to step out into, amen. Another translation, it talks about a man's gift makes room for him and brings him before great men. And so when I'm talking about a gift, I'm not only talking about a talent, I'm not only talking about a gift, but a gift, amen, I think about a gift. I think about, you know, a present. I think about something worth of value. I'm thinking about something that you can bring to somebody
Amen. And it could change their whole day. It could change their whole attitude. It could do a transformation from the inside out. Have you ever brought a gift to somebody? Amen. Have you brought something special? Amen. Maybe to your kids. Maybe you have some kids. Amen. But maybe to your family members. Maybe someone really important to you. You brought them a gift. And you knew they were going through some struggles. Maybe they were going through something, but you brought something to them and it was worth valuing it. And it sparked something within their hearts. It made them feel appreciated. It made them feel valued. Amen. How many of us know we got a gift from God? Amen. We got a gift of salvation that we could boast about, that we could lift our hands and shout to Jesus and thank him for. Amen. So when I think about a gift, amen, I think about something worth of value. I think about not just money, amen. And here tonight, that's one way we could bring our gifts is through money, through giving, through the tithes and offerings, amen. But I'm thinking about, man, what's valuable to us? What can we release, amen? Because it says it opens up the door and it brings you before a great man, or however you want to put this scripture, great men, great. I'm thinking great. I'm thinking great. I'm thinking above. I'm thinking excellence. I'm thinking, man, God wants to take us to another level. He wants to open up the door so we can experience the great things he has in store for us. How many of us know that gifts open doors? Because if it wasn't for the gift sent by God, his only son, his only begotten son to die for our sins, come on that cross, we wouldn't have the gift that we have today. Amen. We wouldn't have salvation. We wouldn't have the healing that he brought into our lives. Because I know many of us could testify. Gang, we could testify all day, all night. Amen. Of the good things that God has done. But if it wasn't for the cross, we wouldn't have the gift. So here tonight, see what that door opens up. That door opens up heaven. Amen. That door opens up heaven. I believe God wants to pour out a blessing upon the gang. How many of us are ready here to give tonight? Amen. Those right where you're at, amen, tuning in live, we want to encourage you. Amen. Let's give that gift to the Lord. Amen. Let's know that he's right there and he's ready to meet every need. He's already met our needs, but he deserves something special. Amen. From us, you know, in the heart of worship. So I want to encourage you just to bow your heads right where you're at as we pray for the tithes and offerings. Father God, we bless your name. We come before you, God. We ask, God, that you would just, God, bless those that can give here tonight. Bless those who can't give. God, even now, God, I pray that you would encourage somebody to step out, Lord God, to begin to understand, God, that you want to open doors for them, that you want to, Father God, see them, Father God, soar, God, Lord Jesus, and begin to excel, God, and see great things take place within their lives. So even now, I pray you bless them, Father, with the seed, so they can give. So those can see, Father God, Lord Jesus, that you have, Father God, the best, Father God. And now, even now, we praise you, we love you, have your way. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you as you give, gang.
I feel like Pac. I shoot the shot. I'm coming in hot. Coming in hot. Coming in hot. Shoot that shot. Shoot that shot. Shoot, why not? Hey, why not? Ain't no big. Ain't no big. Feel like Pac. Feel like Pac. We can't lose. We can't stop. We can't stop. Yeah, coming in hot. Coming in hot. Coming in hot. Coming in hot. Shoot that shot. Hey, why not? Hey, why not? Hey, watch out. I'm coming in hot.
Red and vodka on and popping. Andy Passick car that Stockton. All of a sudden labels chalking, asking for another option. Coppers asking why I'm speeding minor league. Major Deegan trying to take them to the precinct. Lawyer said you need a reason. Spot the kid on Spotify. Yeah. Seen the numbers, they don't lie. Yeah. Yellow birdie in the logo. We on 2 plus the Ocho. High stakes and my funds low. Honeymoon in the bungalow. No shirt, just a gun show. Man, I'm flexing on my exes. I'm in the pocket like bread. Magic and bird like the A's. Starting, but don't try and play. Then I went ghost like I'm Swayze. Two-tone in the Patagon, that's beach and navy. Hasselhoff from the slow-mo, that's extra wavy. And I wrist. I know there's opposition, but it's swish. I know you seen them do it, but not like this. Money make you war and break you. Take the game before it take you lo-fi.
Amen. How many are excited out there on YouTube or on Facebook? Amen. Go ahead and drop a comment right there where you're at. It's a blessing to be here tonight. It's a blessing to be able to come and just have service. Amen. Because
God's great and God's beautiful. And before we even start, you know, I just want to I want to always thank God before I even speak anything, you know. I just want to thank God because he's a great God. There is no one like our God. And I'm grateful because what he did inside of my life. I also want to thank God for our founders, Pastor Sonny and Sister Julie. Amen. Because without their sacrifice, we probably wouldn't be here. And you hear me say it over and over again. But amen. Sometimes we need to hear it over and over again so we can get it in our spirit. Come on now. I also want to thank God for our pastor, Pastor Abel and Sister Reina. If you're watching online, I just personally want to say thank you. Amen. For entrusting us with the gang. I also want to thank God for the team, you know, for J.O., for Ozzy, and for Callie, and also for every single person that's here as essential workers, amen, everyone that's here in the building, and also you right there tuning in online, supporting the gang nights. What? Go ahead and drop a comment, gang night right there, gang night, amen. But tonight, I'm gonna do my best to be quick, but I have a message, but before I even do that, I want to share something real quick. Has anyone maybe on the comments or maybe right here, has anyone ever promised someone something but never came through? Hello, I see hands showing up all over this place. I see two hands showing up right there. Hello. He stood up on that one, amen. So maybe what you can do is maybe throw out a couple of things that you probably promised someone and you never came through with it. Lending money, right? That's a good one. Lending money, where you promise someone that, hey, I promise I'm gonna let you borrow $20, and probably you do let them borrow $20 and they never show up again, or whatever it may be. Because I remember when I was younger, I promised one of my family members, and I was like, look, I'm gonna get you a nice car. When I get older, you're going to be in a nice whip, right? But I never came through, right? Started being lost on drugs and everything. But the reason I'm bringing all this out is because thank God that he's not like us. Come on, I thank God that he's not like me, because I made a promise and I fell short, far from short. You know, I fell completely. And thank God that he's not like us, because how many of us know that when God makes a promise, he keeps his promise. Come on now, he keeps his promise. You know, so tonight what I want to speak on Joshua. Joshua chapter 4, verse 1. And if you're taking notes, or maybe you want to put a title to this message, it's called Get Your Promise. Amen. Get Your Promise. In Joshua chapter 4, verse 1, the word of God reads, when the whole nation had finished crossing the Jordan, the Lord said to Joshua, choose 12 men from among the people, one from each tribe, and tell them to take up 12 stones from the middle of the Jordan, from right where the priests are standing, and carry them over with you and put them down at the place where you stay tonight. So Joshua called together the 12 men he had appointed from Israelites, one from each tribe. And he said to them, go over before the ark of the Lord your God into the middle of the Jordan. Each of you is to take up a stone on his shoulder according to the numbers of the tribes of the Israelites, to serve as a sign among you. In the future, when your children ask you, what do these stones mean? Tell them that the flow of the Jordan was cut off before the ark of the covenant of the Lord. When it crossed the Jordan, the waters of the Jordan were cut off. These stones are to be memorial to the people of Israel forever. So the Israelites did as Joshua commanded them. They took 12 stones from the middle of the Jordan according to the number of the tribes of the Israelites, and as the Lord had told Joshua, and carried them over with them to the camp where they put them down. Joshua set up the 12 stones that had been in the middle of the Jordan at a spot where the priests were carrying the Ark of the Covenant has stood. And they are still there to this day. I'm going to open up with the word of prayer, amen. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you right now, God, and I just pray, Lord, that you'll remove me, remove my nervousness, my God. Remove me completely out the picture, my God. Let your Holy Spirit move with freedom, God. I thank you, Lord. I pray that people will get touched, my God, that your word will go forward, God. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. And I just want to share a little bit about the scripture, because there was a time when God would, when God told Joshua, right, that told Joshua and the people to cross over the Jordan, right? But God told Joshua to call each of these 12, a man from each tribe, right, to collect the stones. And he asked them to pick up the stones from the river and place the stones where they were going to rest, right? And so when they asked about those stones, they could share about what God did. Those were memorials forever, right? The crossing of the Jordan land. So tell your neighbor, get to the promise. Drop it right there on the comment, get to the promise. Amen. And tonight I just want to share on a couple of things. I want to share a couple of things. And before we even start jumping in, I want to look at the Jordan River, right? What it represented, it was a border physically and symbolically, right? For Moses, he wasn't able to cross over, right? But for the people under Joshua's leadership, they entered the promised land. Oh, come on now. They entered the promised land. And the other side of the Jordan River represented libertation and promised ground. Come on now. How many of us want to get to that promised ground? You know, when you're on that promised ground, it's a little different, right? The dirt smells a little different, right? The air smells a little different, right? You start moving a little different, right? When you get to that promised ground. Amen. The other thing I want to look at is the Ark of the Covenant. The Ark of the Covenant represented the presence of God. It also represented faith, right? It symbols where the people could meet with God. He hovered over the Ark when the priests were present, and if the priests were absent, the presence of the law, the tablets reflected God's presence. Amen. So basically, what I'm trying to get at, the Ark of the Covenant represented God's presence. And also, the other thing I want to look at is the Promised Land. The promised land, where God is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Amen. He don't switch up. He's not like us, right, where we'll say one thing and then do another thing the next minute. Amen. The promised land, you know, where it's where we need to get to, right? It's where some maybe, is where we want to be able to see the gang get to the promised land. And I'll jump into all of that. Amen. So my first point I want to look at is, what did it take to get to the promised land? In Joshua chapter 3, verse 5, Joshua told the people, consecrate yourself, for tomorrow the Lord will do amazing things among you. How many of you guys are ready for the Lord to do some amazing things in your life, in your ministry, in your family, in things that you're praying for? Consecrate, right? To make or declare sacred, set apart, or dedicated to the service, to devote or to dedicate to some purpose. And just like in the story, God was calling Joshua to cross over to the Jordan River, to the promised land. And they camped out for months, right? They camped out for months, and they followed the orders that were given. It was a preparation, right? And you can look, and I always love to bring out David. I always love to bring out David because, hey, David is a perfect example of a lot of things. A perfect example where even when you look at him, it took preparation to get where he was at. Come on now, before he even fought that giant, it took preparation. It took preparation before he even went and faced that giant. And where was it at? It was in the shepherd's field, right, with the bear and the lion. And I feel in my spirit that some of us here are at this point in our promised land, right? Where you're about to cross over, right? Where you're about to cross over to that Jordan River. But at first, we need to camp out and we need to consecrate ourselves, right? We need to prepare ourselves. In 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 21, those who cleanse themselves for the later will be instruments for special purposes, made holy, useful to the master, and prepared to do any good works. So how do you consecrate yourself, right? You get yourself through a process. Hello. A process. The process is not beautiful sometimes. Amen. The process burns sometimes. The process will humble you sometimes. The process will put you through changes. Amen. I know I can speak about that because that's what it's done in my life. The process, right? And this is why I'm gonna focus just a little bit on this, the process. Sometimes it don't feel good, but it doesn't mean it's good for you, right? Just because it doesn't feel good, it doesn't mean that it's not doing a good thing, because in the process, it's taking out some ugly things out of us, right? The process is preparing us. So when we do get into the promised land, when we do cross over to that Jordan River, the next thing you know it, we're able to handle the pressure. We're able to handle the blessing. Come on now, we're able to handle the blessing that God pours on our life. Amen. We have to allow God, right? And we have to allow and believe that God placed our leaders there to put us through a process. And sometimes the process doesn't look pretty, like I was saying. It doesn't come in a dove, right? I heard Pastor Izzy say it like this, where it doesn't come in a dove sometimes. The sky doesn't open and the sun is beaming on you, right? And it's a red carpet. No, sometimes it doesn't come like that. Amen. Sometimes it doesn't come like that. Sometimes the process will come dressed up as what? You have to take steps of faith, right? Sometimes the process will come as, hey, you need to conquer fear, right? Sometimes the process will come as being full of nervousness, right? Being full of anxiety, of pressure. But I want to look at the process of gold, right? The process of a gold. And I was looking at a video, right, where they put the gold in a bowl, right? And they light it up for a great while. But the flame, they put it under the flame for a good while, a great while. Some of us need to be put through some fire for a great while. Amen. Some of us need to be put through, but what it does, it takes all the impurity out. What it does, it makes it valuable. It makes it more valuable. It makes the gold weight more when it comes out of that process, right? There's more value to it. Also the same thing with when you're forging a sword. There's a process to everything. What I'm trying to get at is there's a process to things, right? Like, let's look at a forging a sword. You grab the metal piece, right, and you beat it. You beat it, and then you put it in the fire. And then if it doesn't come out right, you continue to beat it. You continue to form it. You continue to shape it into it's ready to be used. And even then, you still have to test it. Come on now, you still have to test it. After you beat it, and after you shape it, and after you form it, you still have to test it so it can be good for battle. Amen. And the purpose of the process is from taking us from infancy to maturity. Come on now, it's growing us. The process is good because it grows us. It's consecrating ourselves, right? Without the process, we are ineffective. If you look at a sword, right? If you look at the sword, and if you have a sword and it hasn't been forged right, it hasn't been made for war, it's gonna break. And it's gonna break during war. And that's the time you don't want it to happen. Amen. That's the time you don't want it to happen. So the process does is seasons you. God puts us through a process because he wants us to be everything that we're called to be. Come on now, because we need to go through the fire, right? We need to face some battles, right? We need to consecrate ourselves, right? We when the devil comes knocking and we're by ourselves, right? We need to have that integrity. Because when the process is over and said and done, God can take us, God can use us, and God can take us to that promised land. Amen? In a time for preparation, right, we don't want to, and I like to look at this, in a time for preparation, we don't want to just come out of the season, right? And I'm talking about preparation. We don't want to come out of the season just being better at what we used to do, right? Manipulating at times, right? Being sneaky at times, right? We don't want to come out being better in that. What the process does, it takes, like I was saying, it takes all the impurity out. It's taking all that out. Amen. The walking up is easy, but what makes it hard is to grab that anointing and go back to the process. And I like this because preparation is getting you ready for war. It's not war yet. It's getting you ready for war. How many of us want to go to the promised land, want to go and get our promise? But we need to be ready for it. Because when God drops blessings, when God starts moving in a special way, when God just moves, period, we need to be prepared, right? We need to be prepared because God can out-bless us. Come on out. God can outdo us. Anytime we try to do our best, God can outdo us. And we got to be, our hearts have to be prepared for that. We have to be set apart for that already. Amen. And I like this because I heard this, and like I was saying, I heard this from Pastor Izzy, right? Where he said, I've never seen God put his hand on something and when he lifts it, it comes out the same. Come on now. And it really spoke to me and it really touched my life because I was like, man, that's so true. That's so true right there with what he's saying. The second thing I want to look at is carrying the presence of God. That's the Ark of the Covenant. Carrying the presence of God. In Joshua chapter 3, verse 6, Joshua said to the priest, take up the Ark of the Covenant and pass on ahead of the people. So they took it up and went ahead of them. So when the people broke camp and crossed the Jordan, the priest carrying the Ark of the Covenant went ahead of them. Now the Jordan is at flood state during harvest. Yet as soon as the priest who carried the Ark reached the Jordan and their feet touched the water's edge, the water from upstream stopped flowing. It piled up as a heap a great distance away. How many of us know that when the presence of God shows up, miracles happen? Come on now, I don't know anyone else. You can call a plumber, you can call people that are professionals in water, but they will not be able to do this miracle. Come on now, we're talking about stopping the river, right? Same thing with the Red Sea. He put a pause on all that because the presence of God was there. One thing that they had to do is they had to carry the Ark of the Covenant across the Jordan River. And in this time, it was in a season where it was most active, the river, right? It was at its most active. And the presence of God, it made space for them. The presence of God made room for them. How many of us know that we need the presence of God in our life, right? Because, hey, I know I need the presence of God, the Ark of the Covenant in my life. Because why? Because my family needs to experience the presence of God. The people that I'm reaching, the people that we're reaching as a gang ministry need to feel the presence of God. Because some people are out there hopeless. They don't know any better. They're stuck on drugs. They're stuck on gangbanging. They're stuck on this lifestyle that they grew up in, right? But when we come around, we're going to be able, because we've been through the process, we've been through that fire, right? We've been forged, we've been shaped, and we've been molded so we can take people to that river, right? We can take people across to that river and take them to that promised land. The presence of God will give you victory even when it looks like defeat. How many of us ever had that? I know I had that many times. It's looking like straight defeat for me. I'm looking like I'm down and out. There is no way that I'm going to be able to win this one, right? I'm walking with my head down. I'm walking in defeat. But I thank God because when the presence of God is there, he gives us victory, right? When the presence of God is there, he gives us that victory spirit, that victorious spirit. And I just want to focus on some things because when God's on the scene, right, he changes things. Look at the Jordan River. Imagine if God wasn't there in the center of it all, that Jordan River would not stop. Come on now, that Jordan River would not stop. That problem, that obstacle would not stop. But thank God that we were able to tap into the presence of God. Amen. When God shows up, he shows out. And he was showing out right there. He was like, look at my son, look at my people. I got you, right? Look at David and Goliath, right? He wasn't able to beat the giant without God. He would have just been like the rest of the army. He would have been just like the rest of the people because these people were trained for war. These people were meant for war. But hey, they weren't able to win, right? But why was David able to win? Because he had the presence, the spirit of God. Also, another thing that they had, right, that they had to do to get there, they had to have faith. Faith will make you step out, will make you step out of your comfort zone, right? Look at Peter when he stepped out, the boat, right? Mm-hmm. faith will also meet you halfway. Come on now, sometimes we just need to step out. Sometimes we just need to go a little out, and faith will meet you halfway. I like this because what faith can do, right? Faith will make you reach your potential. Look at all these people that had faith, and when they crossed the Jordan River, they reached their full potential. Come on now. And this is one thing that really interested me, because people will try to find something wrong in the people of faith. Have you ever noticed that? When you have faith, when you have great faith, people will try to find something wrong in you. Come on now, they will try to find something wrong in you. We're led by faith, right? Walk by faith and not by sight, right? Faith will make you walk like you got a God on your side. Come on now, you got a God on your side. Where you're not walking like, hey, it's just me. No, you're walking like it's me and God, right? I got God on my side. This Jordan River is not going to be able to win, right? This obstacle in front of my life is not going to be able to win. This obstacle that I'm facing right now, this problem that I'm facing, is not going to be able to have the victory, because, hey, I'm going to tell my problem, I'm going to tell my situation that I got a God on my side, right? And when I got a God on my side, that means I got victory. And if I got victory, that means I'm walking with my head high. That means I get a little radical for Jesus, because, hey, I know that I got the victory by the end of the day. Hey, I know that something inside of me, there's something different inside of me than there is in the world. And that's the Spirit of God, right? Faith will make you walk like you got a God on your side. Also, what faith will do, it will take you to the promised land. Come on now, it'll take you to that promised land. It's not going to leave you there, just down and out, beat up, right? Faith doesn't do that. Faith, you know what it does? It whispers in your ear. It tells you, hey, I need you to get up. You may be down and out right now. You may be going through some problems. You may be facing some hard times, but I'm here to let you know that faith will take you to that promised land. Faith will make you step out sometimes. Faith sometimes will make you get uncomfortable. But hey, but once you step out, believe me, God meets you halfway. Come on now, tell that Jordan River inside of your life, I got faith tonight, right? I got faith tonight. Ain't no Jordan River gonna stop me. Ain't no obstacle, ain't no problem, right? That's gonna stop me from getting to that promised land. Amen. And sometimes when we don't have faith, we're trying to fight battles on our natural strength, on our natural strength. But we need to carry the presence of God so we can have victory over all these things. As I call the worship team up, this is the thing where get to your promise. I feel like it was very important that I share these things about the Jordan River and about the Ark of the Covenant, because hey, it was a Jordan River that was in a sense stopping them from getting to their promise. But hey, when they had the presence of God and they stepped out, the next thing you know, all that stopped because the Spirit of God was there with them. Come on now. The Spirit of God is right there with you tonight, right there wherever you're tuning in from, on Facebook, on YouTube. You may be at work watching it, or you may be right there at home with your family, right? And this is what I want to say tonight. I want to speak on the memorial stones and get into your promise. In Joshua chapter 4, verse 7, tell them that the flow of the Jordan was cut off before the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord. When it crossed the Jordan, the waters of the Jordan were cut off. These stones are to be memorial to the people of Israel forever. Right? So the Israelites did as Joshua commanded them. They took 12 stones from the middle of the Jordan according to the numbers of the tribes of the Israelites, as the Lord had told Joshua. And they carried them over to where their camp, and there they put them down. And we're in a season, right, where God's making us pick up some memorial stones, right? Even in an ugly season, even in a season where we're unfamiliar, even in a season where, hey, it doesn't look like life is going to be normal, right? In a season that it looks like They're trying to do the most right now with the church, right? I'm not trying to spend too much time on it, but hey, maybe we can't have church. Hey, we need to go online in a season that's a little weird and strange, right? Even in a season like that, I've been seeing God just pour down blessings still. Come on now. I've been seeing God just moving his hand. He's saying, look, my son, you've been faithful in this season. Look, my daughter, I see you sticking it out. I see you that they have you in a process. I see that I have you in a process. I see that the Spirit of God is falling over your life, right? And what's about to happen, even in an ugly season, in a strange season, I'm about to show up. And when I show up, there's a difference because I show out. If you're trying to throw $1,000 on tithing, I will outdo you. Come on now, but sometimes I need you to step out. Right? Sometimes I need you to step out. We can't outbless God. Come on now, we can't outbless God. And I really started thinking about this. You know what brought all this to my mind? It was the gang home, right? Because I was like, man, God, I caught it. I know what you're trying to say. The gang is the promised land. Come on now. The gang home is the promised land. Because that's something that I've been fighting for. That's something that I've been having in my spirit. I've been crying out. I've been sticking faithful. I've been sticking to the process that God has put me under. And guess what? I started wondering. Hey, God, what about all the other blessings you did before that? These are memorial stones. Come on now. These are memorial stones right here. And I want to share just a little bit of the memorial stones. Because this is how good my God is. This is how great he is. And I won't be ashamed to tell the world how good he is. Because no one else could have changed me. Not no one. Right? No one could have changed my life. And if you honestly knew me before I knew God, you would have been like, yeah, for sure, he's done. Yeah, the people he's around, yeah, he's doing life in prison, right? He will probably end up dead, right? And I'm not saying it to try to look cool or cute or any of that stuff. I'm saying it to really glorify God because God deserves all that glory. The memorial stones. And I started tripping out on these memorial stones, right? Because one of them was what? He brought salvation to my life. Come on now, he brought salvation. He said, look, my son, you're beat up right now. But I'm going to take you to that promised land. You may not want nothing to do with me right now. But there's a promised land with your name on it. I'm going to bring salvation to your life. And as a matter of fact, I'm not just going to reach you. I'm going to reach your mom. Come on now. When no one else could have done these things, he said, I'm going to do it, my son. And I'm going to call it a memorial stone. I'm going to call it a promised land. And I'm going to bring salvation to your life, to your family, and to the people around you, to the city that I send you to. That's where the memorial stone are going to be placed at. It wasn't just salvation to my life, right? He also brought salvation to my mom. Oh, if you knew my mom too, there was no hope for her. That's a memorial stone. Come on now. These are memorial stones that I'm pulling out of my drawer. And I'm like, God, I remember you brought salvation to my life. God, I remember you brought salvation to my mom. And she's still in the church. And she's still sticking it out. And she's still being faithful to the promise. Right? And not just that. I trip out on this because this is all lands to the promised land. If God can do it for a person like me, or I was a nobody, God can do it for you. Hello. I was on parole. I came into the home on parole. Not probation, parole. God said, look, I'm going to discharge you from parole. I'm going to discharge you early from parole. And people that I hear that have parole, they say, hey, that's not possible. Yeah, it is when you're serving God. Come on now. Yeah, it is when you have a promise from God. Yeah, it is. It's possible. Anything is possible when you put God in the center of it all. Not just that. I never had my passport, right? Never had my passport. Never. But God said, look, I'm going to give you a passport. And I'm just not going to give you a passport so you can sleep on it. Come on now, because there's a promise. There's something that I want you to see. I want you to go to Mexico. Oh, come on now. I want you to go to the UTC, right? I'm going to train you. I'm going to equip you. And I'm going to do this so you can show people the memorial stone. Not just that. I'm going to take you on a flight all the way to Amsterdam. These are memorial stones. It's not something that I want to come up here and brag about. I just want to tell you about memorial stones, about the promised land. I'm telling you, you move a little different. You smell a little different, right? Although that flight was pretty different for me. Never been on a flight like that. Well, when God's there, the presence of God is there, and that promised land is right there. Oh, it's going to happen, right? It's going to happen. And not just that. God dropped a car on my lap. When you're seeking to get to the promised land for other people, God will bless you. Blessings will start chasing after you. Come on now. Blessings. Hey, I stopped chasing blessings. Blessings chase after me now. Come on now. Blessings don't stop chasing me. God's like, here, I'm going to pour this. I'm going to pour my anointing over your life. I'm going to pour my power over your life. I'm going to bless you with a car. I'm going to bless you with your family asking you for advice. Right? I'm going to bless you with all these things. As a matter of fact, I'm going to bless you with this gang home, because this is what the promised land looks like. This is what the promised ground smells like. This is what the promised land, this is crossing the Jordan River. And these are memorial stones. These are not something so I can be like, look, I did this. No, because I didn't. Hey, look, Edgar did that. No, I didn't do nothing. It's all God. These are all just memorial stones. And if God's doing this so young and so quick, imagine what he's doing in the next 5 to 10 years. I'm talking about people getting healed on the spot when they come into service. I'm talking about people being homeowners, right? I'm talking about being blessed with blessings from God. Blessings. When you speak to someone, they receive salvation. Come on now. Someone that's going to prison for life, and when you speak on their behalf, they end up getting saved. They turn their whole life around. These are things. This is the promised land, right? I brought out the promised land a little different. I brought it out a little personal, because this is the promised land to me. Come on now. I've been praying. I've been seeking. We've been fighting, and we've been going before God. Hey, God moved in this area. Hey, God, we need you over here. And that's why I tell, and I keep preaching it, and I keep saying, hey, this church, the sanctuary, is going to be packed out on gang nights, right? And we're all going to be witnesses here. We're all going to be witnesses, and it's going to be another memorial stone. Come on now, another memorial stone. So maybe you may feel like, hey, the process seems long. Hey, the process doesn't seem like it's working, right? Hey, the process. Stick faithful to the process. Continue to fight for the presence of God. And when you do that, watch God just open up that Jordan River in your life. And when you get to that promised land, you're going to see blessings. You're going to see God. So right there where you're at, because I know we all need to get to that promised land. Because even after all these memorial stones, there's still more that I need to collect, right? Come on now, there's still more. I want to pile it up. Continue to pile up with the memorial stones. Continue to pile up. I'm trying to build a mountain, right? Before I leave Earth, I'm trying to build a mountain, right? Not for my glory, but for the glory of God. So right there where you're at, just between you and God, hey, there's things that you've been, that God has been promising you. And maybe we kind of got washed away, right? We kind of got kicked to the side a little bit. Hey, but the process is still there. And you can come back and jump into the hands of the process and watch God just move and take you to that promised land. So right there where you're at, ask God for your promised land. Come on now, ask God for your promised land. Thank you. thank you, Father God, for everything that you're doing tonight, God. I place tonight into your hands, Lord. I pray, God, that when we step to our promised land, Jesus, we thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord. There's some in the process, God. I pray, Lord, that they'll be faithful to the process. There's some at the point where they're carrying the ark, right? They're carrying the ark, and they're about to cross over. And there's some at the promised land, and they're building their memorial stones. I pray for wherever they may find themselves right now, God, that you continue to be with them. Bless them, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you, Father God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you, God. Amen. Amen. Go ahead and give Jesus some praise. Amen. Don't forget, next week, we will be having our Third Wave Con online experience. So we'll be watching it online. And I looked at the agenda for the online. It will be Pastor Ryan speaking. And also, on the 31st of this month, someone say the 31st. The 31st of this month, we're going to have Taco with the Gang.
What?
Taco with the Gang. Come on now, Taco with the Gang. You know, it's going to be awesome. It's going to be an outdoor fellowship. You know, we want to encourage you. Your way in is to bring someone new, maybe someone that hasn't been in church. You know, just bring someone new. And, hey, it's going to be food. Just a time of fellowship, getting to know each other, right? The UTC, they call it what? Get to know you week, right? We're going to call it get to know you day, get to know you night. But with that being said, pray that you are blessed with the message. And don't forget, tune in next week. Amen. God bless.